If you allow me to make a big psychiatric point, she says that the shame is the consequence of the killing. I say the shame is the cause of the killing.
And I say it's even worse. You shouldn't be ashamed. You should be mortified. You should be sorry, not ashamed.
How about
ashamed
guilty?
It's almost as though they're holding you up to public, you know, criticism. Therefore, I am ashamed.
Sure, sure.
Not, I'm sorry, I killed the guy.
But back to psychiatry. Freud said...
Back to psychiatry.
Freud said, going all the way back to Freud, that the loss of love generates shame for a moment. That if she lost Travis and couldn't have him, she felt shame. And I say she couldn't tolerate that, so she summoned up a murderous rage. And it was triggered when she went there.
What did you think of the way she reacted?
Just now, if you looked, you saw contempt. And if you put that contempt into context, exactly what you're saying, self-contempt in what she did. So, right, I agree.
All right, Jeff. Now, how could someone who admitted that she committed murder against the murder of someone she says she loved talk about this in such cold and calculating demeanor?
You know, there's been many Jodies on the stand. That sometimes, you know, she's lawyer Jody. Sometimes she's meek and mild victim Jody. Sometimes she's just librarian Jody. The reality is that what you just said for a juror or somebody listening is exactly right. You want to hear them say, I am so sorry I had to kill
Travis. If only
Travis.
I could take that back.
You know, how can she just simply say, yeah, I'm ashamed. It's crazy. And I think the jury gets that.
Is she crazy, doctor?
She's morally crazy. She is detached from her feelings to a fault such that she can do this. She can then go drive and go start making out with some convention guy that she met. She is
speaking of making out. Arias's boyfriend says she kissed him just hours after she killed Travis. Here's her being asked about that one.
How could you kiss another man when you knew what you just did to Travis?
Again, my state of mind wasn't right at that time. This was just hours afterward.
Your mind wasn't right? What say you?
She wants us to say, of course her mind wasn't right, but that's not the problem. The problem isn't what we'd imagine wasn't right. The problem was she's so detached from her feelings. That's not like a broken
Her mind
record,
wasn't right. Then how did she figure to throw the camera in the washing machine to try to wash out
the
memory card?
Yeah, I'm not saying she didn't know what she was doing. I just
covering
think...
up. That's what she's doing. She's covering up.
Oh, so she thinks. Yeah. What did so you think of her body language,
just
Tanya?
Just the detachment. It really is scary to see how she can have that flat affect and then suddenly smile in this way that says, hey, listen, I did what I did. It's over. I'm going to get away with it with her song. Little voice that kind of comes across very young and immature, and she kind of just thinks, let me play it the easy way and see what I can get away with.
All right, Jeff, she says she was a victim of domestic violence and that she killed to defend herself. Is there any evidence of that at all in the trial?
Really very, very little. The kind of things that she says you might get, you know, a nun might do in parochial school. Okay, your mom slapped her, you know, on the wrist with a wooden spoon. And then there is the issue about whether
Did you go to Catholic schools too, Jeff?
Didn't.
I got slapped on the wrist with that.
Judge, it is an offense to every victim of domestic violence that she's claiming this. And I think that by her doing it, she may hurt legitimate victims of domestic violence who need that battered woman syndrome in court.
But what about a doctor, and I'll ask you this, Tanya, as well. They have, in this courtroom, what they call a jumbotron?
Well, big screen.
A big screen, all right, of nude photos of her at pornographic stuff.
Yep.
Is there is she an exhibitionist? How is this going to help her that she's having sex with this guy unless she's in, you know, being beaten or something? And even then, she could be into S&M. I wouldn't put anything past
her. Apparently, she had a camera everywhere she went. She liked to photograph their trips, their experiences in the bedroom. And I think that somehow this is making the jury get overwhelmed, you know, by her tendencies. And I'm not sure how that's going to work legally in the court, but...
Is the thinking that they'll be desensitized?
She's trying to dirty up the victim and say that Travis, you know, was controlling her, that Travis was a sexual deviant. It just dirty up the victim so they don't kill her.
Especially now that you see her appearance and you see how she's completely changed
to 180.
Death penalty. So, let's change this.
You know, she's dressed like, you know, she's a nun with the collar and
Big
everything.
Difference.
Anyway,
difference
great panel. Dr. Sharp, Tanya Ryman, Jeff Gold, thanks so much for being with us.